Hi. I answer to Beau Bridges. But that's not actually my real name. My real name is Lloyd Furnett Bridges III, or as my grandpa Frederick Simpson used to say, the turd. And my grandpa Pack, as I used to call him, because I couldn't say grandpa, so I said Packa. And Pack was the first in our family to go to sea. He was from Liverpool, England, a poor family, 12 kids, and he used to sit on the docks watching these big clipper ships come through. And he stowed away on one when he was 16. And they got too far out at sea to take him back. And he went around the world 7 times in an open boat, that's the way he used to say it. And he regaled our family with all kinds of wild sea tales, you know, about having his toes nibbled on in the hot sun going around Cape Horn when he's asleep on the deck, and then ordered to unfurl the sails in a snowstorm, and his hands getting so cold that he couldn't hold onto the yard arm, and frozen, and he fell one time. Line caught him, dropped him gently to the deck. Otherwise, I wouldn't be sitting here talking to you today. And then I was born 2 days before Pearl Harbor was bombed, December 9th, 1941, in Los Angeles. So they thought the Japanese were going to keep coming to bomb Los Angeles. But then there followed, after World War II, there followed this time of peace. And then there, Kennedy put up the Cuban blockade. And we thought that we were going to go to war against Russia. There was talk of a draft. I was 17, a senior in high school, and my dad said, "Son, maybe you better pick your branch of the service and join up, because at least you can do that. If you wait for the draft, you're not going to be able to decide which branch you go into." And my dad at that time, he was an actor as well. He was doing a series called Sea Hunt, my father Lloyd. And because of it, he met a lot of the Coast Guard personnel because they were coming on as advisors for the show. And so he promoted them a lot. And because of his interest in the Coast Guard, they gave him an honorary commission of Commodore in the Coast Guard. So part of the reason I'm here today to receive the Lone Sailor Award is to honor my father's military involvement in the Coast Guard. And then 8 years after I joined up at the age of 17, my brother Jeff followed, and he served in the Coast Guard Reserve as well. I served my time in between two wars. So I served in peacetime. And when they called me for this award, I said, "Geez, you know, I hardly think of myself as a veteran." I said, "The real veteran is somebody who's seen some, you know, wartime action. Those are the people that I really appreciate, military personnel." And the gentleman that had called said, "Well, you served, didn't you?" And I said, "Yes." And he says, what's your motto, the Coast Guard?" I said, "Always ready." He said, "Were you ready?" I said, "Yeah, I was." He said, "Well, then, that's why we're acknowledging you." And but then I had many friends who fought in Vietnam. Some gave their lives. And so I do have a profound appreciation for military personnel who have served in wartime. My uncle was Fred Simpson, Jr., was a merchant marine. And he served in World War II, so I actually told me a lot of stories about it. And I have friends, people I know, and I think particularly in this time, Iraq and Afghanistan, I mean, horrendous battles. And you know, I appreciate so much the men and women who serve us and defend us at this time. I don't think we really appreciate the returning veterans, their wounded warriors, as much as we should. Especially those that come back and want to re-enter into civilian life, we need to be much more supportive of them than we are now. It's another reason I'm here.